Okay, chapter 3. It is about attitudes and job satisfaction. So, definitions of attitudes. Attitudes are evaluative statements. So, when we talk about attitude, we talk about whether it is favorable or unfavorable. So, sometimes we have favorable attitude towards something, sometimes we have unfavorable attitude towards something. So, it's reflecting our feeling about something. So the component of attitude consists of three types: affective, behavioral, and cognitive. So we have affective related to our feeling, behavioral related to our actions, and cognitive related to our evaluations of our actions. So these three things, affective, behavioral, and cognitive, will cause our attitudes whether to have positive or negative towards something. For example, in this light towards supervisor is based on our affective, behavioral, and cognitive. So according to the study, if you read the textbook, there's a theory called consistency, because when we talk about affective, behavioral, and cognitions, our attitudes need to be consistent. For example, affective, behavioral, and cognitions, normally if we have positive here, we will have positive here, we will have positive here. If we have negative, affective, negative feeling, normally our behavior would be also negative, our evaluation would be negative. If we have positive feeling, then our action also will be followed by positive, and evaluation also will be followed by positive. So that's a consistency. That means if it is negative at the cognitive, at the is also will be negative at the affective, it will also negative will be behavioral. Let's say if it is positive here, negative here, negative here, that's called the cognitive cognitive dissonance. So cognitive dissonance can happen where there will be incompatibility that individual or the person may perceive between two or more attitudes, between behavioral or between behavioral and attitudes. So what is meant here, instead of consistency in terms of whether negative, whether or positive, is a combination. When cognitive dissonance happen, is meant that there will be some incompatibility in terms of their attitudes, behavior, and feelings. So I give example here. Cognitive dissonance will happen if any of these three element of attitudes consist of a combination of either positive or negative. If it is just all negative, it's called consistency. If there are some, for example, negative, negative, and positive, is called cognitive dissonance, because our human being, they were being created in terms of their feeling, their cognitions, and their behavioral need to be consistent. If we have our feeling, we tend to have positive, then our cognition normally evaluation also positive, and also our behavior also positive. So cognitive dissonance normally happen when there are some inconsistency regarding the feeling or cognitions of behavioral. So the major job attitudes, so we talk about major research, especially OB, regarding job attitudes consists of three major parts: job satisfaction, job involvement, and organizational commitment. So now we are talking about the outcome when we talk about job attitudes in terms of job satisfaction, job involvement, and organizational commitment. We talk about the outcome of organizational behavior. So there are also, in addition to these three, for example, we have perceived organizational support, employee engagements. There are two more major, but the most important, we talks about the outcomes of job attitude is job satisfactions, job involvement, organizational commitment, perceived organizational support, and also employee engagement. So job satisfaction, perhaps you already are familiar or you already know when we talk about job satisfactions, is our positive feeling toward our job, maybe resulting from the evaluation, our evaluation toward the job. Maybe we satisfied with the job itself, we satisfied with the working condition, we satisfied with the salary and so on. So overall, we have a positive feeling about the job. So that's called job satisfaction. Job involvement is referring to the to what extent the employees or person identified with the job. So job involvement, where the employees identify with the job, they are more engaged in the job, they are also actively participates, and also they consider performing the job itself is important for their own self-worth. So job involvement is considered the outcome of the attitudes. I mean that's actually the results. So job involvement, so what happen if employees have this kind of feeling, it will lead to high job involvement. That means the tendency of the employees to involve in the job, to actively participate in performing the job and so on. Psychological empowerment is referring to the degree of influence that the employees think about how to complete the job, or they may have some competency. Employees themselves may think that they have some competency. So they have this kind of this kind of power. It's not really power. They have this kind of belief in themselves that they can perform the job, or they find the job meaningfulness. So basically, psychological empowerment is the organization give the employees the autonomy or the freedom to do the job. For example, if you work for the company give you a freedom how to perform your jobs. For example, they give you a task to do, and then they just let you do your jobs, give you a power to determine your own job, but I mean in terms of their performance. So what is meant by psychological empowerment? I may be explained in length here, but the point is, when we talk about psychological empowerment, is the freedoms that the organization give to the employees to work on their own self. I mean, based on their competence, normally based on their, maybe they have the competency, they have the skill, the experience and so on. So the organizations, the manager give them, allow them to determine how to perform the jobs. So that's basically psychological empowerment. So empowerment is referring to freedoms or autonomy for the employees to determine to how to perform the job. Organizational commitment is referring to the identifying how employees identify themselves with the goal, with the organization in terms of goal, in terms of values and so on. So because of they identify with the organization in terms of organization values and goals, so they become loyal to the organization. They want to maintain the memberships in the organization. That means they do not want to resign if, let's say, they found another company gave them more salary, but because they thinks that their current organizations congruence with their values, they fit with the organization in terms of goals and values, so they want to stay longer with the current organization. They become loyal. So basically, when we talk about organizational commitment, we talk about how loyal are the employees with the organization. So when the employees are more committed, they be less likely to engage in work withdrawal. Work withdrawal mean is a kind of way how to overcome from pressure, or from if they do not satisfied, they will engage in work withdrawal. That mean in terms of they may resign, they may perhaps when we talk about withdrawal, we come late because we do not want to work, but we have to come. It's like a work withdrawal. Normally, this work withdrawal is like when employees feel dissatisfied with their work, maybe dissatisfied, or maybe it's not really loyal to the organizations, so they tend to come late, maybe find ways not to come to work and so on. So that's considered as a work withdrawal. Another major job attitude is perceived organizational support, where the employee perceive or believe that their organization actually values their contributions and also care about their well-being. So this actually increase employee perceptions that their organization actually support them. So perceived organizational supports are very important, especially for employees who have many workloads. Maybe working in the factory, they have to work they have to work longer hours, they have to stand for a long times, they have to doing repetitive job. So this kind of job can be stressful, especially if their manager do not have this perceived organizational support. If the manager come to them and values their contributions, care about their well-being, even though the jobs are kind of very hard, difficult to do, maybe they have to work for a long times, high workloads, regular shift and so on, this would not affect negatively on employees, because they perceive that their well-being are actually being looked after by the organizations. So normally, perceived organizational support is considered high when rewards are fair. So when the employees believe that they are being rewarded fairly, so they tend to have high perceived organizational support. So they tend to involve in the decision making. Maybe the organization, when they want to decide on something, they will ask the employees' opinion regarding this. And employees normally volunteer to help to involve in decision making when they believe their organizations or their manager provides supports very helpful in helping them, the employees. So when they found out that their supervisor are very supportive, so they tend to involve more in decision making, they tend to put more effort in performing the job. Normally, organizational supports is very important in the country that have power distance that are lower. So in the country that have power distance that are lower, that's mean in the developed country where the gap between followers and the leader are quite low or short, that means they have a close relationship between leaders and followers. So perceived organizational support are normally can easily seen in the organizations. So when there is perceived organizational support, employee tend to give more input in the decision-making process. So next is employee engagement. This involve this referring to employee involvement with the job with the organizations. So normally employee tend to involve more with the organizations activities and so on if they satisfied with the job and they found out that the activities are more interesting and so on. So employee who are engaged, they normally passionate about. If they do not like the organizations, they will not want to involve, I mean, in the activities or in the job, performing the job and so on. So employees who involve in employee engagement, they normally feel deep connection with the organizations. And if they feel if they feel dissatisfied the organization, if they feel the organization didn't look after their well-being and so on, they tend to disengage with the organizations. That means they do not want to put time, energy and so on in engaging or involving in the organizational activities and so on. So moving to job satisfactions, like I mentioned, job satisfaction is a positive feeling about job based on our evaluation. That means it's a subjective, because sometimes our feeling toward organizations are good, so it's a positive, sometimes it's negative, so it depends on our subjective feeling. There are two approach how to measure job satisfaction among employees. First one is through single rating. That means I asking you, are you satisfied with the job? You will write no. For example, disagree, disagree or satisfied, dissatisfied, highly satisfied, and so on. So that's a single rating to ask employees whether they're satisfied or not. The other one is using the summation of many questions. In for example, in terms of nature of the job, supervision, and so on. So if the employees are dissatisfied with this,